happy to be here, honestly. Hey, we love it.
Literally the most cheesy, only understand if you're British joke.
Yeah.
Yay, because our surname is Paula. I could let you have it. Okay, so I fully mapped out everything that I wanted my family to see. There is so much in San Francisco and I wanted them to experience it how I've learned to see it, which meant starting with the Mission District. It's full of meaningful graffiti and murals, so I took them to Clarion Alley. I think this just gives you a lot more real picture of San Francisco, especially with like the influence of tech and gentrification and locals' opinions on it. And I also took them to one of my favorite vegan restaurants, this Mexican restaurant called Gracias Madre. And they had never tried boba before, like bubble tea, they'd never had it. Again, that's been crucial to my experience here. So many of my Asian friends swear by it.
I kind of like it.
Yeah.
I've never had any like it.
You chew it. I then took them to one of my favorite spots in the whole city. The top of Mission Dolores Park has the most gorgeous view of the city. Everyone here just comes to chill. Look at it. Whenever I take people here, I do this thing where they have to trek up this whole hill. And I say they're not allowed to turn around until we get to the top. So there's like this whole suspense. And then you get up here and look. And then I took them to the highest point in the city. This place is iconic. It's a bit of a trek, but it's just gorgeous. Man. Like, look at these views. That's Market Street, where we were in the morning.
Well, it's can't do it justice, honestly.
Today we have done the Mission District. They tried boba and good vegan Mexican food. We went to the Castro. We've done Twin Peaks and Dolores Park. We've got free tickets to the SF Symphony tonight. And I think we might even try and go to Chinatown. We'll see. I think when other people come, it makes me appreciate just how much I love this city and how much I know about this city now. Being able to be a tour guide is just fun. Yes, Mom! How shocked are you by the naked men in the Castro?
I don't even know what to say. It's weird.
I feel like I've just gotten used to it.
You just love taking me here now, don't you?
No.
I honestly thought you were joking. And then I just see it like 5 times straight away.
This is the most naked men I've ever seen in the Castro. It's quite intense.
I don't think I've ever felt so uncomfortable.
That day we went for brunch, we just walked around, we went thrifting in hippie hate Ashbury. We mainly just shopped, it was fun. Such a beautiful day.
I'm loving it, honestly.
Get ready for one of the best sunrises of my life. Looks like someone got rejected on Valentine's Day. No! It's like I'm on a plane looking out over there. It's crazy to think when we first came up here, we couldn't even see like 5 meters ahead of us. We couldn't even make out the lines of the bridge. Like, we couldn't see anything.
I'm back!
Yay! Wow! How do you feel?
Amazed. Louisa used the word plot twist.
Yes.
Mad.
After those insane plane-like views, we went to Golden Gate Park. I showed them around the lake. We climbed up to Strawberry Hill. It was just gorgeous. We made it to Strawberry Hill.
Hey, we did it.
I am amazed how much we're managing to do in one day. Waking up at 5 a.m. That is how you see a city. And then we just walked through Richmond and went to Palace of Fine Arts. That night my family was so dead and jet lagged, but I went to Land's End with my friends and some of the people who were on Ascent. They're like prospective students who've been admitted and they basically come for pretty much all paid for weekend just to see what Minerva's like and they live with us. So yeah, we took them here. I've never actually been to this point, so it's just gorgeous. I just felt like a child. We were just scampering in the water. We were just climbing rocks, watching sunset, amazing. So I had to do some work in the morning, so my family just went and did their own thing. But then I took them to China Beach. I've never been here as well, but my mum really wanted to go because she just read about it in a tourist guide. Hello!
Hey!
Hey!
day? What have we been up to?
Filming TikToks.
Yeah, I'm attempting to try TikTok. I said I would do it last time and I didn't, but I want to try this time.
It seems like whenever I'm with you, you film TikToks.
I feel very inspired by Folkert's TikTok energy.
Mm-hmm. I'm just made for TikTok, clearly.
Folkert is leaving tomorrow.
Right.
What has been your highlight?
I'd probably go for when we got to the top of Twin Peaks and just looked out to the whole city, view of like literally everything.
Gorgeous. I can't believe they leave tomorrow. The plights of international students when their family like finally visit. Why?
I don't think I can cope.
My vlogger. Where are we going today?
Pacifica.
I found an angel and she lives here now. But I can't get her out my cage. It's a hawk! Gordon, what are we about to do?
We are meditating.
We're about to meditate.
Yes.
Gordon is like
the at
meditation
the edge of the
master.
Ocean.
Yeah. Yeah. Do you meditate every day?
I try to.
Place to meditate. This is crazy. Literally just after I finished meditating, I like softly open my eyes, look into the ocean, and there are dolphins! Like actual dolphins, guys! I'm sorry about that meditation.
They are so tired.
I just like started crying. I don't know, I just got really emotional for like no reason. I just feel very full. Oh, we just hiked all the way up to here. Gordon, what have you got?
I got this.
Whoa! I missed this.
Yeah.
Where did you get this from? Roller skate, can you roll skate?
Yeah.
Would that make you happy on this hike?
Maybe.
Guys, I'm sat here watching this as I'm bogged down in assignments and I'm just like, oh my god, take me back.
Don't stay. Come with
don't
us.
Stay.
Come on. You know you want to come to England. Big con.
You're so cute. Hey there, guys. Okay. Wow. So, homesickness. Maybe you are watching this at university, or maybe even university abroad, and maybe you miss your family and friends a lot. I think homesickness is one of the most like universally relatable things for people who are traveling. Like, it's just weird, you know? You're going through all these changes, you're meeting all these people, you've literally lived your whole life sometimes, you know, with your family, and then all of a sudden you're like, bam, you're released, you're independent. I think for me personally, I don't get that homesick unless I'm like stressed or feeling low, or I don't know, just like sometimes you just want to speak to your mum, you know? And I think it's different for everyone, because personally, if I speak to my family more, I get more homesick. Like, I'd rather just focus on life here. Whereas I know other people get more homesick if they don't talk to their family. So I guess it's just like figuring out what works best for you. Being really honest, one of the things I struggle with the most is knowing that, like, as an older sibling away at university, I am missing out on so many just like small moments of my brother growing up. Like, every time I see him, I'm like, you have not only grown, but you're just like, you're like different, you're like changing, you're, you know, you started A-levels and stuff, and like I'm not there to like see it and like chat with him just on a daily basis about how it's going. And that's weird. And it's those aspects of homesickness which are like really hard, because you can't replace them. But at the same time, I guess it's just trying to like remember why I chose to come here long term. It's for the best. My family is still there, and just like, what a luxury to have them here. Like, it literally felt like my two lives, my old life back in the UK, my old life, and then this new life with like all my Minervan friends and like my whole like new knowledge of San Francisco and stuff, like all this stuff they've not seen me do was like combined. Like it was so strange seeing them in my room. Yeah, I know so many of my friends here like don't have the opportunity for their family to just like come visit. So yeah, I'm just super grateful they could be here. Mum, Dad, Folk, I love you. I know you're probably watching this, so I love and miss you. If you're missing your family, I feel that. Pretty much every student feels the same. Reach out to a friend or something if you need to. Talking about it can make it feel better. Sometimes not talking about it, just going, sitting on your own for a little bit makes it feel better too. Looking through photos, I don't know, whatever you need to do. Yes, adulting is a strange thing. The like transition phase between teenager and fully independent. And yeah, if you're watching this and you don't talk to your family that much and you're at uni, I hope this can just encourage you to like reach out to them again, you know, maybe like ask them for a FaceTime call, because even if you're experiencing all these amazing new things and you don't feel homesick at all, I bet they miss you. Thank you so incredibly much for watching this video. I'm sending all my love and positive energy to you. Have a beautiful rest of the day. See you.